god. It's full of chores.
I played X Rebirth for about 30 hours this week, and most of that time was spent looking at this. I gave it 2 weeks. I really tried to get into this thing. I really tried to dig deep into it and see the appeal, but I can't. I just feel lost. And I don't think that the problem is my own personal biases, or even that it's technical stuff like glitches and bad AI. The core game, deep down inside this thing, is either broken or unfinished. I've seriously tried to figure this game out, and that's the only conclusion I can reasonably come to. Where do I even start? I guess, okay. X Rebirth is a space trading and combat game, which also serves as an ambitious reboot of the X series. Rebirth aims to deliver a more personal view of its expansive universe by including extensive first-person dockside gameplay, as well as having the player pilot just one ship, as opposed to the usual fleet of controllable ships from the previous games. It's got a new streamlined interface designed to be more visually appealing to new players, while also offering the series' unique depth and complexity for the veteran players, and all of that is bad. Take the interface, for example. They say they want to simplify it for new players, but why are all the functions divided up into scrolling tiers of little radial menus that only show 6 options at a time and lag for a second between every click? And I get the idea of the cockpit being there, but why is there no free look, and why are there no bearings, and why can't I keep the minimap on? Why are there no menu hotkeys? You have an inventory, but you don't press I or Tab or F1 or whatever for it. Instead, you press Enter, wait a second, then 2, wait a second, then 1, wait a second, then you hit the DE button in this table, which actually stands for details, even though there's no tooltips or instructions telling you this, despite there being lots of blank space and big font, so it's not like they're running out of room. And speaking of that inventory, that's a whole nother can of worms too. You pilot one ship in this game, the Albion Skunk, and the Albion Skunk is not a freighter. It has no cargo space for trade wares, so you can't fill it up with stuff and then sell that stuff someplace else. But you can. You have an exhaustive personal inventory of a different kind of item called inventory items, and the distinction between trade wares and inventory items is completely arbitrary. Food rations are a trade ware. You have to go through the long and complicated process of loading them up onto a hired cargo ship. But chocolate rations are an inventory item. You can snatch up hundreds of those from the ground by yourself with no problem. The whole interface suffers from that problem. There are just too few buttons for how many different things you need to do, and nearly every element of it suffers from some kind of critical design flaw, and you end up having a lot of necessary actions get buried underneath lots of convoluted submenus. The core game is about managing a trade fleet of space freighters who buy low and sell high, and my god, the steps it takes just to give one of those ships one basic order is exhaustive. And you can only queue up 3 orders at a time, so once you have a small fleet going, you're gonna spend more time wrestling with these menus and your ship's AI more than you're gonna spend flying around exploring and getting into combat yourself. This game is so bad that even the AI doesn't want to play. Your hired ships either follow you or they don't. You can send them on up to 3 trips, and there's no way you can automate that process at all. You can't give them waypoints or cancel orders or tell them to wait without ditching them out of your squad completely, which just leaves them vulnerable and idle at whatever place they decided to plant themselves. There are so many counterintuitive design decisions that almost seem built to lead the player the wrong way. Like, say you want to repair your ship. That's easy, just go to an engineer. But say you want to repair one of the ships in your fleet. You don't go to an engineer for that. You don't go to a mechanic. You don't even go to a ship technician. You go to a ship dealer. And that's only if they sell the same kind of ship that you want repaired. Because I guess in the 31st century, proprietary license parts are still a problem. Or maybe that's just one more convoluted, unnecessary rule that the designers didn't thoroughly think through. The game is full of those. The reason I say that is because over the course of the campaign, you'll gather a little fleet of light freighters that you can't maintain, because the NPCs that could repair them do not exist. The only guy in the game who sells the ships you'll actually be working with is locked off until the endgame, and the missions that get you there are so broken at the moment that the only people, to the best of my knowledge, who can actually get there have to edit their savefile XML to make it happen. But before you actually can start hauling space commodities from one space warehouse to another, you have to make a few contacts first. You have to land onto some space stations and walk around these awfully copy-pasted and disorienting metal hallways and deal with the buffer of wasted time that adds. And is it just me, or do a lot of these dialogue lines seem a bit strange to you?
Isn't everything real? I'm not sure there is even such a thing as virtual. It's virtually impossible. Do you know what a stereotype is? It's a superstition and a shallow opinion about a race based on a brief experience of just a few. You really don't want to fall for it.
If only I could express myself as well as you can. I enjoyed our chat so much that I'm feeling generous now.
Can I show you anything else? I do mean anything.
This game has so much innuendo that even your co-pilot's head is in the gutter. So the main quest has your character salvaging this spaceship out of some wreckage in the middle of nowhere when a confused German international student shows up asking how to get back on the Autobahn.
Some drones have abilities you can activate. They'll launch, do their thing, and hopefully make it back safely.
Warning, the following section contains spoilers for a story that I hope you never experience. She just waltzes into the cockpit like she owns the place. One thing leads to another, and after hours of crashes, bugged objectives, and roadblocked progress, your dude gets swept up into an epic civil war between an evil corporate mining empire and the one outlying system resisting their dominance. Which is all well and good as far as the usual space sim stories go, but keep in mind that this isn't a space combat sim. It's a space trade sim, and the main storyline, should you choose to follow it, turns the dominant economic powers of this world against you. There's not much trading you can do outside their borders, and this is why I'm inclined to say that the game's not just broken or buggy, but also unfinished, on a design level. It actually looks like they never got around to adding the resources and the NPCs that make completing the campaign possible. I soldiered through it, but I had to really scum the quicksaves on my way there. The main quest forces you into a faction that has no ship fuel for FTL jumps, no cheap ship dealer, and no good merchants to do trading with, and then gives you objectives that pretend that that didn't happen. The objectives expect you to travel your fleet through a heavily guarded portal and make the trip over and over again until you can get some supplies to the other side. But even if you do decide to make the trips, you're gonna hit one annoying, unexpected roadblock after another. Like how you need cargo lifter drones, but the game doesn't tell you when you need those, it doesn't tell you how you need those, it doesn't really tell you what they're for. You just gotta Google it. And if you go out of your way to buy one of the bigger, more expensive ships, because that's all that's available, you're also going to need to buy a defense manager and some interceptor drones and an engineer, because your freighter's always going to get pecked at by the bad guys. And even once you have all that set up, don't be surprised to see your drones just get stuck or just disappear out of thin air. That's why you gotta quicksave a lot. Here's an easy fix. They could have just given the skunk just a little bit of cargo space to work with, so you can speed over to the other side, dodge the guards, grab some fuel, and then run it back to your freighters, and then suddenly you'd have an open fuel supply pipeline and an option for fast travel and room to experiment with how the game works without taking a 20-minute highway trip every time. But you're not gonna be able to do that. Because of where they've placed these resources, your progress is going to be roadblocked, and you're gonna have to abuse those quick saves. You're gonna have to spend hours upon hours of your life watching your ship travel from one end of the galaxy to another, literally stuck in line in traffic on these wormhole highways, and the whole experience will just be one huge chore. Is this really the worst game I've played since Postal 3? Oh my god, I don't want it to be, but it is. That game was deliberately bad, and Rebirth actually gives a damn and has ambitions, but this is so sad. It could have been so much better. The ideas are there. It could have even had some good faction play. There's a handful of independent factions you can ally yourself with, but you can't really prod engagement between them and get some interesting story or benefits out of it. This isn't like playing the Stormcloaks against the Imperials, this isn't like supporting duty over freedom, and this sure as hell isn't like the complicated faction interplay between the NCR and the Legion. The main story develops just one of its factions. It forces you to pick one side of this conflict, even though that clearly isn't how the game is meant to be played. The layout and the balance of the world just doesn't support which factions own what territory, and even when you're not pursuing the main quest, it's not like there are any meaningful side quests to distract you. They're all MMO-style guff, without stories or characters attached. Just shoot up X number of bad guys or deliver X number of supplies for money and reputation points, and what are you gonna do with reputation points besides get more money? I could understand why you'd want to load up the free play and chase after some delusion of a huge, powerful trade empire without any obligations to the main quest, but even that doesn't work right. It's still missing the necessary NPC vendors that can sell you that cheap, small trader fleet to get started with. In the campaign, you're given those as rewards for missions. Without a line of main story quests, the game is broken, and you end up spending hours farming for captured capital ships that you can't do anything with. It's missing critical pieces to its own puzzle. The dialogue lines just don't fit the mood or the character of the game. The interiors are just the same two nonsensical designs copy-pasted hundreds of times over. There's even a looting system, but that doesn't make sense either. NPCs don't react to you stealing their shit, and you won't earn a lot from selling it. But since there's no downside to looting besides wasted time, then there's no reason not to waste your time doing it. The main quest doesn't fit the map it's placed on top of, and the single ship radio menu cockpit interface doesn't fit the design or the scope of the game itself. And to make it even worse, it seems like development of all those features was halted to a dead stop before they just threw this work in progress out onto the market. Remember when you were a kid and you would look up at the night sky and maybe think that you were born 1,000 years too early? You would think about going on all kinds of wacky and exciting space adventures before crashing back down to reality 10 years later and realizing that you spent 30 hours of your life pretending to be a stressed out, overworked space supervisor who has a dead-end, low-wage space job shepherding a small company of brain-dead space truckers. You're pretending to service the local space grocery stores and putting up with all kinds of space bullshit because your high-tech 31st century spaceship has only 6 buttons. You're spending your precious free time on Earth pretending to be a pissed-off blue-collar middle manager, and you find yourself getting mad about grumpy old white man problems like how no one knows how to speak English and the corporate government is cracking down on free trade and oh my god, why is this so bad? I'd really like to be able to say that this game might be good after years of extensive patching and modding. It just doesn't deserve to be in this state. But from what I'm seeing right now, this looks awfully close to being unsalvageable. It's almost unplayable. It'll be years before this thing is in working order to be sold to the public. But until then, avoid it like the plague.